Adrian is safety, safety is Adrian. Our occupation as a business in terms of various projects and scope, the primary prerogative that we've made as a commitment, both to the client, to the employees, to the interested parties, that's the public, the community, and also our own subscription to the various membership, including the Global Compact, is that we'll at all time ensure the safety of our people.
Over the period, I think the last 6 years, we have worked tirelessly. There have been a tremendous efforts in creating an enabling environment where, you know, it allows the safety culture to thrive, and we have done this through several initiatives. We set a specific budget annually, which is executed quarterly, just to ensure that all the basic requirements as per the Safety Act are provided. We also empower the team through trainings on the specific areas, like pole climbing, work at height, first aid. We bring in other safety experts to continuously help the team embrace, you know, the importance of safety through continuous programs of health and safety awareness.
The safety team at Adrian usually have a head of department. Directly under him, we have two team leaders, one in administration and the other one in operation. And then we usually have safety coordinators who are distributed across the divisions and also departments, depending on the project teams.
This year, in the month of March, when we take retreat, try to see where we are in our business. This year, in the year 2022, we had an opportunity to look at our business for the last 2 years, especially, you know, after the COVID period. And we actually realized that the behavior, you know, the safety, that culture of the staff to take safety as their own personal initiative is still a big gap, you know. So we made a deliberate and anonymous decision that we have to adopt safety as our value, and that way it becomes a DNA for each and every member of the staff, and they will understand and take it as their own role.
We really had to come out and prove a case that indeed we have really walked this talk. We've really made a lot of milestones, and we've really achieved quite a lot towards proving that safety is no longer that talk we had along each other's desk, along the corridors of the organization, but rather a conversation which now comes in to encompass our own compliance, our own commitment, and our own wellness, both emotionally and mental health.
Our safety process for employees starts at induction, which is usually done when we have a new employee or colleague. Then after that, we ensure that they're equipped with the necessary protective equipment, and also as they head to site, they've been equipped with also the appropriate site safety equipment. Then after that, we have our team going around doing safety trainings on site, and also inspecting the teams just to ensure that they comply with our health and safety guidelines.
Some of the risks we face on a daily basis as FTTA technicians include the worker site risk, there are slips and falls, also encountering pets at clients' premises. Let's talk about the snakes and the bees also in the manholes. At Adrian, they have facilitated us with trainings. First of all, trainings on concerning the matters of safety, and also they have provided us with the PPEs and site equipment in case of any safety emergencies. We are quite right to act upon them.
Each one of us can uphold safety as a core value by first understanding what safety is, having a personal commitment towards safety, understanding the benefits and risks associated with safety, and how they affect them as an individual, their family and also the business.
Our key asset in the success path of Adrian business is the people. We know that the success of this business is 100% dependent on the people. And with the people, there is talents, there is commitment, there is dedication. And therefore, we have an obligation as a company to protect the workers. That is key. And secondly, we also have a commitment with our customers to promote the best practices in health and safety. And lastly, I think is our call of duty to promote and adhere to health and safety act as far as the industry that we operate in is involved.
If we could achieve safety at the psychological level, in that it's already in me, not in we, that I need to embrace and practice what is required and perhaps go beyond what is expected of me, then that will eventually mean, even when it comes to the business, we've all matured as far as the standard of expectations is concerned. Then we'll wake up really a very safe people, and we'll even have now more time to think strategically on how best we can support business and also our team at advanced levels, as opposed to what is known to be the groundwork.